Yeah!
Hi guys, so welcome to the first 1000 rounds on the CZ Scorpion Evo 3S1. And I'll tell you, what a blast. First 1000 rounds behind us, it was a complete mixture between the steel-cased ammo and regular bronze ammo. Steel-cased ammo was from Wolf, regular ammo was from Winchester, and Sieler and Blood. The reason for the mixture was, I was just basically looking which one is cheaper and which one I can snatch cheaper on the net. So anyhow, zero malfunctions. Let me say this again, zero malfunctions. We have been using the CZ magazines, which were donated, by the way, by guys from the Copper Customs, but also from the Prepper Gun Shop. Thank you very much. Awesome. Thanks for helping on making this test possible, guys. But going back to the magazines, as you can see, this is the newer mag with the thicker feeding lips, but also I was using the older CZ magazines, and I understand there were some complaints that on some of these magazines people were having problems with cracked lips and things like this. This is obviously something what we will be looking for. This is the whole idea behind testing that gun, to see how all those parts, internal guts, are going to perform, and are they going to withstand the shocks and impacts and everything. Yes, this rifle will take a swimming test and everything, but today we started, as always, with the gun barrel test. So basically 25 yards distance, and I'm shooting the five first rounds of cold barrel on the target. Then I'm going to another location. I'm doing a 3 magazines dump, so basically 90 rounds dump to heat up the barrel, and I'm coming back to the target, and again I'm shooting the 5 rounds to see how much of the shift we have in the groups. This is not accuracy test. Basically this ammo, this is not the target ammo by any stretch. But we just want to see how the groups are shifting from when you are heating up the barrel. And as you can see, it was very minimal shift. I can totally live with that. So that's kind of impressive how the CZ did that. Speaking about the accuracy, I did shot that rifle on paper, to put it on paper with the accuracy from 100 yards, and you can see this is the group. Not bad, I would say, not bad for the basic shooting test, but I will tell you, I took it to the 150 yards, 200 yards, and you have no problem being on a steel target with that 9mm carbine. It's absolutely a blast to shoot, fun, zero recoil. Everyone loves to shoot that Scorpion Evo. Ola is having a fun with it, Paul was having a fun with it. Everyone who I'm giving that carbine to shoot is having a blast. That being said, guys, enough with the bullshit talk. Let's dive in and see what's happening inside the guts. Let me push the pin and hopefully we'll be able to remove, there you go, the bottom portion. Look at that, look at all that gunk, junk and everything. This is all from the a little bit over 1000 rounds, guys. Nothing has been cleaned, but I don't see anywhere, I don't see much wear on the trigger hammer or anything here. Let me release the trigger for a second, and on the back this is all looking good. So that's the trigger mechanism, disconnector and everything. We'll see how this is all going to perform. Let me have a look inside. First I will release the and pull out the bolt. Let me put this aside. Basically this is the bolt carrier unit, the integrated bolt on it, and then you can call it this recoil spring buffer and things like this. So let me have a quick look on the metal parts. I can see some wear here, but I don't know, maybe that's normal. This is just below the firing pin. You will see, of course, better pictures on your screen. and a little bit here. We'll see how this is going to develop again. This is my first time with for the extended period of time with CZ Scorpion Evo. Maybe that's normal wear, but we'll be watching it. But the extractor claw, even after this hard steel case, is looking perfectly fine. I do not see any damage on it. There's a lot of junk and gunk and things like this on it, but it is looking good, and the polymer and all here is looking good as well, at least for now. As I said, we'll continue to monitor this and document the progress. Let me have a look inside that upper portion receiver, how this is looking like. This is what I want to see, how this is all going to act and react, and if we're going to see anywhere. As of right now, I do not see anything jumping out of the shell and telling me that this is all bad. I'm looking at the chamber. There is a lot of dirt, a lot of gunk, but that's it's a blowback system, so this is kind of expected to be that way. As I said, zero malfunctions. I'm not going to clean that portion, guys. I do not want to clean that because I want to see if this rifle can withstand all the 5,000 rounds without the cleaning of this area. So we'll see how this is going to perform. So far, so good. As you can see, I have on it the ACSS Cyclops 1X Prism, one of my favorite optics for this style of the weapon. This is jelly perfectly with this Scorpion. Something to keep in mind if you are looking for the optic. They are really, really good for this kind of setups. All right, guys, as I said, we'll continue to push all the rounds forward, and we'll see what's going to happen. So far, so good. First 1,000 rounds behind us, zero malfunctions, and a lot of dirt. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for supporting us, and thanks for being with us. Let me know if you have any questions.